This kind of reminds me when they were arguing in chapter 9 about who's the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Jesus says, don't worry about being seen by men. Just worry about doing the things that you're supposed to do. You guys know that I'm an attention hound. You know that. I like to get on Facebook and post videos and things of that nature. I enjoy that. Somehow I've got to stop this. Because I talk about tree stuff all the time. I enjoy it. It's like a big giant playground for me. But when it comes to ministry, I don't tell people what I do. I don't tell people what the needs are out there that I'm meeting. I don't tell you how I help somebody or counsel somebody or go to somebody's house. I don't do those things. And it's not just because they're private things. They are private. It's because God says that if I go boasting about the things that I do here on this earth in order for you guys to see it, then I ain't getting nothing out of it. I already got my reward by simply telling you. Now you say, well, Brother Clayton, that's not necessarily true. There's a fine line. When we go and do disaster relief and we bring back a bunch of pictures, we know that evangelism or missions is more contagious when you can actually bring back some tangible pictures that people can see what you're actually doing, where their monies are being spent and the things that are being accomplished. So we do that. But we don't do it for the accolades. We do that because we want to try to inspire you to do likewise, and it doesn't have to be disaster relief. It can be all kinds of things. And so I try to balance that with trying to be a sense of encouragement and not seeking accolades for myself. Like I said earlier, I know that some of you are the most selfless, most precious people that I've ever met. Everything that you do is for the Lord. And I'm so blessed to work in a church that has people whose hearts are bent towards Jesus. I know that some are likely doing things for the Lord that none of us have any idea about. And that's good. It's under the Lord. Yet inevitably, sadly, some will never break that inertia that I talked about earlier. Always opposing the force trying to push them forward. Also being on a path, not willing to bend towards the path of Jesus because we're headed in a certain direction. Hudson Taylor was a missionary to China. And his story, and a couple years ago, I did, I think it was Pastor's Picks, and we did biographies. And one was on Hudson Taylor, and I've read his biography a couple times. He was a missionary to China. He was born in 1832 and he died in 1905. And he was a mover and shaker in missiology. Hudson Taylor went to China with disrupted financial flow from England and he had a very, very difficult time. It took him years before he saw his first convert. The reason that he was groundbreaking as far as missions goes is because Hudson Taylor, unlike all the other missionaries, he decided to wear the garb of the China, what they dressed in, and he actually grew a Q-U-E. It's the long hair that he had back in the ponytails. Hudson Taylor spent 11 trips or went to China 11 times. His longest stint was 4 years. His health prohibited him from staying a great deal or great lengths of time, but he was there 11 times. In those 11 years, he had 9 children, and he lost 5 on the mission field. Not only did he lose 5, he lost his wife on the mission field. He lost 2 daughters and 1 son and his wife in a 3-year period. Can you imagine what that would do to most people to have that kind of loss in a short period of time? It would cause a person to be just kind of stuck. It hurts, but they're looking over their shoulders. Do you know that Hudson Taylor did all this, being put in prison, having his, he translated the Bible from English out of Hebrew and Greek into Chinese, and the Chinese government took it away from him, and people tried to hide it. He had a terrible time. And he did all this while he dealt with depression his whole entire life. You're like, I don't know how he can do that. He kept his eyes on Jesus, because Jesus could always get him through there. Always get him through it. I know that when we talk, we often talk about either ministries or things that God wants us to do or not do, about open and closed doors. And we have a tendency to define an open door as something that's easy for us to just walk right into. God must have opened a door for me. And difficult things is where God's closed the door. But if you look over the biographies of the missionaries, you'll find that almost all of them went into some very difficult doors. And I just want you to know that the devil opens doors as well. On Hudson Taylor's 11th visit to China, he died there. Hudson Taylor commented on his work. He said, China is not to be won for Christ by quiet, easy, loving men and women. The stamp of men and women we need is such as will put Jesus, China, souls first and foremost in everything, at every time, even life itself must be secondary. Meaning that Jesus has to take place over your own life, over your own priorities. Now, as we come to a close, I'm going to ask Brother Town to play a song of invitation. As we consider the words that Jesus said, unfit for the kingdom of God, what are you focused on? If you don't stay focused on Jesus, your life is not going to get better. Your marriage is not going to get stronger. Your health will not get any better. Your moods won't improve. Your relationship, even with Jesus, is not going to grow if you don't keep your eyes on Jesus. Nobody's going to come along and mystically all of a sudden make your life better with Jesus. The only way that your life gets better with Jesus is if you actually do something with Jesus. Even ministry won't get any better unless you keep your eyes on Jesus. So I'm going to ask Town to play us a song on invitation and ask you, what are you keeping your eyes on? Remember Jesus' words. He says, unfit for the kingdom of heaven. Are you fit for the kingdom work? Are you fit for heaven? If you don't know whether you're fit or not, I pray that you would come and talk to me either this morning or give me a call this week. We can sit down and talk over coffee to see how this might play out in your life. I'd love to do that. But if you're ready to work for the kingdom of God, come down this morning and let us know.
Please stand if you're able.
I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted. You were condemned. You were forsaken. I'm accepted. You were condemned. I'm alive and well. Your spirit is within me because you died and rose again. Amazing love. Die for me. in all I do, I honor you. I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted, you were condemned. I'm alive and well. Died and rose again. Amazing love, how can it be that you, my King, would die for me? Amazing love, I know it's true, and it's my joy to honor you in all I do. I honor you.
Please pray with me. Lord God, we thank you for this time to hear your word preached, and we pray that you will raise up amongst this congregation many Hudson Taylors to maybe go to China or India or Africa, or maybe just in our backyards and in our families, and that we will always move forward to share your kingdom with our group of people. And I pray now, as you wrote in Jude, now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, dominion, and authority before all time and now and forever. Amen.
Our ascending song will be the chorus of Stronger.
God, stronger, you are stronger. Sin is broken, you have saved.